What I do expect is that we are able to come up with electrified solutions for short-haul operations, which means in a range of, let's say, up to 1,000 kilometer flight distance. I think in maybe 20 years, we will have at least a hybrid electrical power and maybe liquid fuel powered airplane. And the longer we are putting the time scale, the more this kind of hybridization will grow. So let's say in 30 years, we will maybe able to fly from here to Madrid on an electric power basis. For this full long haul missions, flying from Europe to Australia or to Far East, so everything which is above, let's say 10,000 kilometers in range. I don't think, based on flight physics, aerodynamics, and how do engines operate, we will be able to have that on a full electrified basis. Not in 20 years, not even in 35 years, in my opinion. We have started this project, Energy System Transformation in Aviation, in November 2016, so half a year ago. And the general aim of the project is to come up with methods in order to assess how we see potential solutions of aviation transport within a time frame of 15, 20, 25 years up to the final time frame of 2050. Within that project, we have defined three what we call core areas or core teams. One of those is the flying vehicle, the airplane itself. For sure, it plays a fundamental role within future air transport. The second core team members are focusing on what energy form are we looking to. That can be batteries, electric energy or power. It can be based on different new synthetic fuels by replacing kerosene by something which is produced out of electric energy as a synthetic liquid fuel. But it can also be liquid hydrogen, for example, in order to come up with a solution which is then tailored to the aircraft mission, since we are focusing not only on short-haul missions flying from Hanover to Munich, for example, but also on long-haul missions and everything which is in between. And the third core team is dealing with the what we call overall system assessment. So since we have just described flying vehicles and energy supply, we need a method how to assess and analyze all that in order to come up with the real, let's say, hard facts, which is operational costs, which is how long is flight time, and also what is the social acceptance of all that. Assuming that we want to have increased mobility also in the future, are we willing to fly in aircrafts which are flying slower than today? So are we willing to spend more time in the air if that is cheaper than flying as we know it today? Or do we want to fly supersonic? Are we willing to pay more in order to be from here to whatever New York in 3.5 hours instead of 7 hours? And it's also something which has to be put into or transferred into methods which can then be used to analyze the transport system in order to come up with some, yeah, maybe to call them key performance indicators in order to say, well, that kind of aviation we are expecting in 30 years is giving the following facts and performance. Whenever we are talking about new vehicles, that means airplane combined with an engine, it's on noise and it's on pollution. It's on carbon dioxide and noise emissions. So from my expectation, noise reduction will apply on both us being a passenger sitting within the cabin and being exposed to cabin noise, which is dominated by engine noise, but also aerodynamic induced noises. But that also applies towards us not flying within the aircraft, staying on the ground and being exposed to the aircraft starting and approaching airports. And if we have more point-to-point connections using more airports within medium-sized cities, that will also drastically raise the demand of having quiet solutions. And that means quiet aircrafts and quiet engines. If we have a future airplane that is in its basics able to being operated or manufactured for 30 years, we need some flexibility for transformation in between, that we are maybe starting with an energy system within that airplane which has a mild electric power hybridization degree of, let's say, 10 or 20%, but then 10 years later we are changing the energy storage system within that airplane to a degree of 20 or 30%, and that is then this transformation aspect within the product or within the given aviation environment, which we do foresee as a significant requirement. The idea of these interdisciplinary teams is to have teams formed out of experts from aerodynamics, from structural analysis, how to build an airplane, but also from experts dealing with energy conversion systems, dealing with electrical energy storage, up to the experts we have in order to do this economic assessment, and also what I would call social expectation assessment. And therefore we are using, or we have in our team also experts from the University of Arts here in Braunschweig within the team, mainly focusing on this scenario development, looking into 2050 year expectation, which is 25 years in future. Means there are a lot of possible scenarios, and those scenarios, they will require different technologies. And whenever there's a scenario becoming more likely or less likely due to changing constraints from politics, from the economy, then we have to, let's say, switch from one scenario to the other, and then developing or at least assessing the technologies which are required for that scenario for our aviation dream then. We are focusing on 35 years time scale, so we are a little more, let's say, flexible and free in thinking and coming up with new ideas. But we do assess these new ideas or the technologies which are then derived out of those new ideas. We do access those within the same framework of regulations and constraints which are on the table today. To give an example, if we are thinking about an airplane technologies to fly more efficient, then we do not only assess those technologies based on the new ideas we have for a typical, let's say, normal mission, which is we are cruising in our targeted or typical flight height, but we are also applying the rules or regulations which are dealing with unexpected situations, like we have an one engine off scenario, so the airplane is just flying with one engine if it's equipped with two engines, or we have to deal with an aborted takeoff on a given length of a runway. And all these typical regulations you have to fulfill if you want to get a certification for a new airplane in our days, we are also taking as rules for our technology development, in order to, let's say, avoid that we are coming up with a great new idea, which is great if it's just doing what it's supposed to do, but it's not able to be operated in a typical environment.